Hey everybody, it's Frank from Motorvate here. I just want to share with you this latest update. So it's the same gauges being displayed, but I spent a bit of time just to kind of make them look a little bit more elegant. So we've got, you know, blue lines for cold temperatures, orange lines for warm temperatures, and red lines for hot temperatures. And so it just sort of builds in a little bit of guidance into the gauges with regards to these different fluid temperatures. So again, on the top left, we've got engine coolant temperature. Top right is engine oil temperature. Bottom left is the air fuel ratio for bank one. And the bottom right is the engine oil pressure. Now, the big thing I really want to show is I've been able to use a button on the steering wheel to do this. Change pages. So I've been able to capture the data of the cruise control on-off button and set up an algorithm so that if you hit the button twice within a second and a half, it will change the page. So now we're looking at the air fuel ratio for bank one, and for bank two on the top right, the engine coolant temperature, and the bottom right is the engine oil temperature. Now I'm gonna hit the cruise control button twice again, and we also will be having wheel speed, as well as I will be able to provide real-time tire pressure for each tire using this exact same layout. So that is going to be kind of nice to see. Hit it again, go back to the first page here. Again, engine coolant, engine oil temperature, air fuel ratio bank one, and engine oil pressure. And again, the gauges, they're still responsive. They're working quite nice. So that's kind of where we're at right now. The next step is I got some optimizing I need to do. As I continue to add pages and data, it's got more to process. So I'm gonna be using something called RTOS, which is a real-time operating system, so that I can actually have, believe it or not, a little bit of multitasking going on. So I can fire up dedicated tasks on specific cores, and that way it should make everything as fast as possible, and that's the goal. So just wanted to share that with you. I've got more work to do, but in my opinion, I'm really liking the layout of those new that new layout there. I think it's just looks nice, and you don't want to know how many hours it took, because I am not a graphic designer, I'm a hack. So it was a lot of trial and error, because I got to draw it before I have any idea of if it's going to look good or not. But that's what we've come up with. So once again, here's the first page, cruise control twice. Here's our second page, cruise control twice again, and our third page. And we'll go back to the first. Also, if we just happen to hit cruise control once, like we want to use it, which I've just done, it doesn't impact anything. It needs to be pressed twice within a second and a half. So it was a kind of a balancing act between the convenience of using the cruise control on-off button, because it's on the steering wheel, it's right by your thumb, it's very handy, and that way it's a completely hands-off device. The other option was to use a touch screen, you have to reach over and touch it, but I kind of like the idea of using a button that's already part of the car. So that's what we're going to be going with. All right, that's all for now. Thanks, everybody.